My name is Seyi Shay. Some people call me Seyi, some people call me Shay, whichever is easier to pronounce. I'm a singer-songwriter, and I'm an entertainer.
Delby! Seyi Shay. There.
I grew up in London, in the UK. My parents are both Nigerian. From Nigeria, from Lagos. My mother used to sing in a choir at church. My brother was a DJ. There was a lot of music going on in my house growing up. Like, my earliest memories of music or even singing along to anything was probably when I was about 4 or 5. I used to follow my mom to choir rehearsals, and I used to go into my big brother's room when he would mess around on his decks. And so I think that the love for music or the inclination for music started from about the age of 5, really. When I was around the age of 9, I knew that I really loved music. By that time, I was really like into anything music. I was into Michael Jackson, I was into Madonna, I was into Destiny's Child, that late, you know, it just, I was into SWV. For some strange reason, all I wanted to do at school was music. And so I think at that point, I knew that that was probably what I was gonna do as a career, like for the rest of my life. And then when I got to age 14, I went on a tour with my gospel choir. I was privileged to go on a tour to Japan with my gospel choir. And the experience was so amazing that I came back off the tour just exhilarated and knowing exactly what I wanted to do, what I wanted to be. I had the opportunity to sing in front of hundreds and thousands of people in Japan, like all over Japan at such a young age, that I came back to London saying to my mom, "Mom, I want to sing. That's what I want to do. I want to be a singer." Live performance was actually at school on stage, and I just remember being really, really scared, so scared that I had practiced this one particular note in the song for weeks and weeks and weeks and weeks, and by the time it got to the actual performance, the actual night, I bombed that note because I was so scared, I was so nervous. And I was like, I think 11. Yeah. My past few songs have been quite safe, I would say, but in a good way, not in a bad way. When I say safe, I mean, you know, the message has been universal. It's been quite popular as in pop, but at the same time, real and actually from a place that's real lyrically, and I like real music too, but I'm moving towards a side of me where I'm being a bit more risque. Delby. She. There. I'm being a bit more bold and brave. I'm talking about our femininity, being a young woman, the things that we like, the things that we really want to see, being independent, but also, you know, being feminine. And so in my forthcoming album, I'm really gonna talk about some things, and you'll see me do things, and you'll see me portray really what it is that I'm sure every woman or every girl really would like to talk about or touch on and yeah, explore. Preparing for my performances sometimes could take months, could take a day, could take a week. Every performance is different. I like rehearsing. I feel like practice makes permanent. And so it really varies. It depends on what kind of performance it is. It depends on if I'm performing with a band or my dancers. I spend the whole year rehearsing with my dancers, whereas I spend maybe like 2, 3, or 4 weeks rehearsing with my band, coming up to like a group or set of shows. So it's different, it varies. I prepare in different ways. They call me shady foreigner. I'm running London and Houston town. Whatever goes around comes around. I'll be to the break it down. When I'm on stage, the thing that goes through my head is, how am I going to reach that set of people, that one person that's really going to walk away being a fan or a lover of Seyi Shay? That's all I care about when I go on stage. I don't even care about how my mouth moves or how my mouth goes when I sing. I just want to affect people. That's it. Just how am I going to affect this crowd? I've had several embarrassing moments. You know, I've had moments where I've sang my heart out and nobody clapped. I've had moments where I've fallen down on stage, you know, and people did clap. I've had moments where, you know, the wardrobe wasn't so good and, you know, things popped open and you know, you're having to hold it together and just keep singing because it's a show and you have to keep on entertaining. You know, I've had a few embarrassing moments.